You can put the license that you have received from PVSYST via email. Or, on the right side, you can request online activation, or click on the grid connected option here. Wow, the interface is looking great. Hi guys, how are you? Hope everyone's doing well. Jenny here with you today. We are starting the PVSYST learning series. We came up with the idea of presenting the lessons in smaller and to the point for each steps, so that your attention and interest both will be with PVSYST and PVSYST only. Nothing else. Please subscribe now to our channel and press the bell icon, so that you will not miss our future uploads on PVSYST and solar PV system design. Without any further ado, let's start. First, we will go to PVSYST website, and from there, click on the download section. At the beginning, you can see the installation requirements. It says that you cannot install the software in sharing network, which means one license will work in only one computer or laptop. You cannot share with other colleagues or friends the same license while using it in your own workstation. Fourth point is very important. Do not change your system's time settings to tweak with the software's license deadline. It'll detect eventually and suspend your system from working any further. You'll lose all your progress. So, beware of this. Next is required config to run the software. Pay attention to the OS requirements. If you are Mac or Linux user, you have to use VirtualBox to install and run this app. If you are facing any issues, you can directly contact the support team. They are very quick in resolving such problems. In system config section, the minimum requirements are very low. Nowadays, any i3 or above computer comes with such configuration. Now download the software. Click on the download button and wait till the setup file gets downloaded. It's 286 megabytes in size, so will not take much time. We'd like to mention here that when we are making this walkthrough, PVSYST just launched the 7.0 version. So, it might be higher version when you are actually downloading the file. Don't worry, the process is going to remain same for future versions as well. After download, click on the file to start the setup wizard. Please note, you must be using the system as administrator to install it. It is very important. So, once you double-click on the setup file, a new setup window will come up like this. Click Next. Again, Next. On this screen, PVSYST will ask your permission to install the .NET into your system. Just click Next here. After the installer package gets downloaded, it'll ask for your acknowledgement with their user agreement. You can read all these if you have time. Or simply, check the box, I have read and accept the license terms, and hit Install button. The download of .NET Framework version 4.5 will start. Just wait till the download and installation process gets completed. It'll take some time. For most cases, it'll take 15 to 20 minutes. Just be patient with it. Once the .NET installation is complete, click the Finish button. Then, on the next window, it'll ask you to restart now or restart later. Please choose Restart Now. It's important for this setup and for the stability of the PVSYST later on, while you'll be using it. After the restart, PVSYST setup window will come up like this. Click Next. On the next window, obviously, click Accept Check button, and click Next. In this window, PVSYST will ask your permission for data collection. It's totally up to you, whether you want to give consent or not. We have opted out from this. Now, select the installation directory. By default, it's the system directory. After setting it, click Next. Again, Next. And now click on the install. Installation will start, and it'll take hardly a minute to complete. After installation completes, click Finish. It's now starting? Okay. While starting up, PVSYST will ask you for workspace allocation. Please note that this space has to be local. Google Drive or Dropbox kind of storage drive will not work. Here, PVSYST asks for three different type of directories. First is a fresh new directory. You can change the location from browse option. Second option is to copy data from your previous installation of PVSYST. So, you can assign the existing directory for previous version and new path for PVSYST 7.0 directory here. And the third option is to use the previous installation's directory only. We have selected the first option here, and keep the default path for the directory. Now click OK. Next, PVSYST will ask for software activation. If you have already purchased the license, then you can click on the Activate button. Or if you want to purchase now, then click on Purchase. If you click Activate, then PVSYST will give you two options for the activation. On the left side, you can put the license that you have received from PVSYST via email. Or, on the right side, you can request online activation, or load license key. Very easy process. Just a few clicks, and your software will be ready. Now, in our case, we decided to proceed with trial option. As we use the license on a different workstation. After completing the license process, you'll get your PV system design window. Finally, on the bottom right corner, you'll see two options. One is manage, and other option is switch. These are about the work directory that we have set up in the beginning. Under the manage option, you can see the entire project and component root directory here. In our next video, we'll show you how to import components and projects into PVSYST. Let's see the design window interface after closing this window. Here, on the top menu bar, PVSYST shifted the preliminary design option. The total interface is changed here from previous versions. Nice work, PVSYST team! We'll check the functionalities and update you segment-wise in our upcoming videos. Subscribe our channel Minutes to Energy and press the bell icon to get the notification of uploads. We'll be working on new uploads and share with you every Thursday. Before we call it for the day, let's look at the project design workspace quickly. Click on the grid connected option here. Wow, the interface is looking great. On earlier versions, as you can see here on the right side of the screen, it was very normal and minimalistic. On this version, they have worked a lot, we guess, on the interface. Looks nice? We'll explore these features on our upcoming lessons. Please let us know how did you find this video helpful in the comment section. We read all of your comments. And please like and share the video as much as you can. Do subscribe to our channel, Minutes to Energy, for more upcoming and interesting videos on solar PV system. Like, how to start a solar business. How to design solar PV system and solar panel manufacturing process. Thanks for watching guys till the end.